magnifying glass here. Our job for today is to look at the upper appendage model. So we're going to start with the shoulder, go all the way to some muscles associated with the thumb on the hand, and then we're going to finish up with some spinal nerves. We have five of those to name. So we are looking, of course, at the backside of the shoulder. We can identify first our deltoid, which is on our chart for origin, insertion, and action. So the deltoid is, remember, abducting the humerus, so the origin is up here at the scapula and clavicle, and the insertion is actually that deltoid tuberosity of the humerus. I'm gonna go ahead and dissect mine. And now we're looking at the backside of the scapula with the muscles attached. We have this structure here, which we call the spine. Now we have three muscles of our rotator cuff to name. We have the supraspinatus, which is going to be above the spine. We have the infraspinatus, which is below the spine. And then we have the teres minor. If we go ahead and look at the anterior view, our fourth rotator cuff muscle is visible here in the subscapular fossa. This muscle is called the subscapularis. So our rotator cuff muscles are the supraspinatus, infraspinatus, teres minor, and subscapularis. Going back to the posterior view, we also can see this muscle of our shoulder called the teres major. So again, you have teres minor, which is smaller, part of the rotator cuff, and teres major, which is not part of the rotator cuff, but it is here on our shoulder, and it's larger, which is why it's called major. Okay, next let's take a look at the muscles on the front side of the arm. The muscles on the front side of the arm have the job of flexion, so that will help us to keep the name straight and also help us on those muscles that are on our chart. So we are looking at a left arm here, and we're starting with the muscles on the humerus. The humerus is, of course, our arm bone, so any term brachium, brachial, brachius is referring to the humerus. Our first muscle here is the biceps brachii. This muscle is, of course, going to flex the forearm. The origin is up here at the scapula, and the insertion is going to be on the radius. We can see that we're on the thumb side or the radial side there. If we dissect off the biceps brachii, we can see right underneath the brachialis. If I put my biceps brachii back in place, I can see it from the side. So biceps brachii, brachialis. My next job is to look at the muscles of the forearm. So I'm starting on my lateral thumb side, and I'm gonna work my way across the medial or pinky finger side. So I am gonna start with my brachioradialis. If I am doing like a left-handed, handshake, I can't show this on the video very well, so I'll just stop with that. Okay, brachioradialis right in line with the thumb. The brachioradialis is named for origin and insertion. Origin is, of course, the humerus, brachio, and the radialis is, of course, for the radius, and this muscle is responsible for flexion. From the brachioradialis, I can work my fingers across to my pronator teres. Then I can find my flexor carpi radialis, my palmaris longus to the palm of my hand, and then my flexor carpi ulnaris. If I go back to my palmaris longus directly underneath, I can see it here and here, or I can dissect and see it here. This is my flexor digitorum superficialis. Okay, so one more time. Thumb side, pinky finger side. Brachioradialis, pronator teres, flexor carpi radialis, palmaris longus, flexor carpi ulnaris. Go back to my palmaris longus, moving down towards the wrist. Right underneath is the flexor digitorum superficialis. All right, we are now ready for the posterior side of the arm, which contains our extensors. So just to remind myself where I've been, I'm going to find my biceps brachii, my brachialis, and then I can see the three heads of my triceps brachii. Triceps brachii is going to do extension of the arm, so the Humerus and scapula will be the origin, and the insertion is the ulna, which I see I'm on my pinky finger side. Okay, then I'm going to, again, remind myself where I've been on my forearm. So I'm going to start with my brachioradialis, and I'm going to work my way across towards the back. So brachioradialis, extensor carpi radialis longus, extensor carpi radialis brevis, extensor digitorum, and look, my tendons go to the fingers of my hand there. Extensor digiti minimi or digiti minimi go into the pinky finger. Then I have my extensor carpi ulnaris, and up here in the elbow, my inconius. So I can do that again. Brachioradialis, which I found on the front as well. Extensor carpi radialis longus. Extensor carpi radialis brevis. Extensor digitorum. Extensor digiti minimi or digiti minimi. Extensor carpi ulnaris and the anconius. To finish up the muscles on this model, we need to look at the hand. So I'm going to be going from the lateral side around to the web of the hand. We have just four muscles to name here. So from kind of my outside view right here, I can see my opinions pollicis. Next, I have my AB abductor pollicis brevis, flexor pollicis brevis, and then on this inside web of my hand, I have my ADD adductor pollicis. To finish up this model, I'm going to dissect off several things here so that I can look for my spinal nerves of my brachial plexus. The term plexus is referring to a nerve network. Brachial is, of course, the nerve network of the arm. So we have five spinal nerves to name here. So let's begin with our axillary nerve. Axillary is referring to armpit or, You can see it on the back here. Okay, from my axillary or axillary. Next, I can trace this nerve all the way to my pinky finger here. This then would be my ulnar nerve. I'm on top of the ulna. Then in the middle of the arm here is my median nerve, which I can trace down. The next nerve that my finger gets to right here, I can see right on top of the brachialis. So this is underneath the biceps brachii. This is the musculocutaneous. And then on the forearm, underneath that brachioradialis, right here, I can see my radial nerve. So axillary, ulnar, median, musculocutaneous, and radial. And let me go ahead and stick that biceps brachii back in place over top of my radial nerve. I'm putting the flexor muscles on back on my forearm, and I'm putting my biceps brachii back on top of my musculocutaneous, and that's it.